Yo, what's up everybody, this is JC from my own pocket. What I got before you today is some gameplays I'm gonna do with this Asus ROG G14 gaming laptop. This one is a 2021 edition and it comes with a 1 terabyte of SSD, and it's been my favorite gaming PC so far. I love it so much. I use it more than my PS5. It's just a fantastic machine, and the battery life is pretty good as well. I usually get like 2.5 to 3 hours of gameplay, and it charges up real quick. Usually this bad boy is at 60 hertz, but I selected to 144, because that's the maximum this one have, 144 hertz. So you could select it either one you want, 60 or 144. I like 144, I keep it high as much as I can. The first one I'm gonna crank up for you guys is Forza Horizon 5. And this gaming laptop handled it pretty well. So let's go in here real quick. Let's crank it up. Boom. So beautiful that is. Let me just go up some more for you guys. This is my favorite controller right here. This one, I pick it up. It's the Power A. And with the RGB lighting, it's awesome. Beautiful RGB gaming controller. The texture outside is Alcantara, so it's very soft touch. The analog sticks got a grip like the Xbox, like the real Xbox controller, so it's like a grip, so it gives you more grip. All right, you hear that, Ryan? Grip. Okay, boom, beautiful.
This is the final drop. The whole festival is waiting. We've already had cars falling out of the sky, but all eyes are on the superstar making their way to the festival right now. If you've just arrived at Horizon Mexico, then you are in for a treat, my friends. Get ready for the biggest Horizon adventure of your life. Did you hear that? Well, that is the last inbound cargo flight racing neck and neck with an AMG-1. Mexican Fiesta Party people, and we are just getting started. Please welcome our number one superstar.
Thank you. Liberty City is in shock today as the police and emergency services deal with the aftermath of a devastating attack on a police convoy this morning. As yet, no details have been released about the prisoners being transferred in the convoy, and no group has claimed responsibility. The convoy left police headquarters early this morning for a routine transfer of felons to Liberty Penitentiary. The attack took place on the Callahan Bridge, leaving few witnesses and the bridge itself severely damaged. Some of the convicts are thought to have perished in the explosion that followed the initial attack. Revelations as to the professionalism of the attack struck police hours afterward, when identification of the missing felons were further hampered by an attack by computer hackers on police headquarters databases. With the Porter Tunnel project falling behind schedule, this disaster leaves Portland isolated from the rest of the city.
Come on! Señor Dickhead! It's no problem to kill you. You're gonna be sorry. Aye, get lost.
No place on the edge of the red light district where we can lay low. My hands are all messed up. You better drive, brother.